My name is David Kuo, and we're at NIH NCATS. We are looking for better ways of finding toxic compounds in the environment, and these compounds that would ultimately be exposed to humans. I was born in Taiwan, in China, but I grew up in the U.S. I lived all over the place. I lived in Illinois. I lived in Brooklyn, New York. I've always been known as a gadget guy, so I like cameras, I like electronics. Went to work at a pharmaceutical company and ultimately decided that I wanted more challenges, so I moved down to Maryland and finally ended up here. A company will make a new Band-Aid, and there's the sticky component of the Band-Aid gets used on humans. And so we want to make sure that that sticky component, that chemical that they're using to make the stickiness, doesn't affect humans. It doesn't cause any kind of infectious disease. It doesn't cause any kind of rashes, things like that. So what we're doing is to increase the throughput of compounds that we can test, as well as decrease the cost of testing these compounds. So in order to increase the throughput, we use a lot of robotics because it just it helps us to do things in a more controlled manner, as well as to run unattended. So things that we can do by hand, we can do. It takes sometimes longer to do by a robot, but it can run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, which is what helps us out. So we're basically just setting up the deck so that everything is set up right, and then we're going to put the toxicants in there, and then we're going to have the cells also on the same deck, and we're going to add the compounds to the cells, and then at that point we're going to wait a certain period of time, stop the assay, collect the cell lysate that's going to be used for the next step in the process. You know, it's the technological advances as well as the scientific advances that really push us and drive us on a day-to-day basis. And these are things that kids love playing with, computers and gadgets and toys. Well, I get to work with them all day long, and that's like a wonderful thing. These are endothelial cells that have been treated with cigarette smoke. So this is part of our collaboration with two other groups, both at NIH, and we are looking at the effects of cigarette smoke on endothelial cells. So what you can actually see is the cells that have been treated with smoke, there's a lot of dead floating cells. This is after only 40 hours, and the cells that have been treated with the control, they look much nicer, and they're well attached. The cells look much healthier. The work that we do at NCATS is done on a huge collaborative manner. So most of the work that is done here is done in collaboration with other labs, other groups, universities, companies. So that's what NCATS is all about. When are we sending the samples out to June for the sequencing?
So we hopefully to send it out next week.
Once this is all set up, then we can get more cells from Manfred on a continual basis. Not just cigarette smoke, but a lot of different factors involved in tobacco. We're looking at something that could potentially be a paradigm shift in what we do with compounds that are destined for humans. So instead of waiting years and years for approvals of pharmaceuticals or for chemicals that companies put out, we're hoping to do that in a much shorter time period so that people that need medicines will get it faster, and people that will benefit from various chemicals that companies put out will also benefit. I think the best thing is to listen to your advisors and supervisors. People have spent years acquiring this knowledge, and that's something that we need to get into the younger generation, is to learn from the experiences from others that they have gained over the years.